Greetings. A year ago, you would have been surprised to see me wearing a mask, especially outside of a medical or laboratory setting. And the thought of thousands of students lining up every week for a health test would have raised further questions. And if you told me that I'd be presenting a giant nasal swab to help mark our coronavirus test number 100,000, I might have laughed or walked away or both. Of course, we now know this is our reality. It's still hard to reconcile how much our lives have changed over the past year and how quickly we had to pivot. It's a year to the day, March 11th, that I advised our community of the shift to remote learning. In that message, I noted that we were acting out of an abundance of caution. Little did we know what lay ahead of us. Since that time, more than 500,000 Americans and millions more around the world have died as a result of COVID-19. And countless others have had their lives irreversibly changed. It's important we recognize the hardship and terrible pain so many of us have endured. As a nation, a community, and individually, we've paid a heavy price. But I also want to focus on what we've accomplished and the journey we've taken together. It's not enjoyable to wear masks and maintain social distance, nor is it ideal to reimagine and rework class structures under impossible deadlines or to build new schedules with little warning. And I know from personal experience how hard it is for students and their families to limit their travel and interactions. None of this is what we would choose. But it has been essential, and it's something of which we can all be tremendously proud. Despite the challenges and the skeptics, we were able to safely resume and maintain an in-person campus experience. Our students rose to the challenge, helping us achieve some of the highest testing and lowest positivity rates in the nation. And our researchers, data science experts, medical professionals, and so many others contributed critical insights to the fight against this virus. Above all, we came together as a community to make this happen. We've demonstrated a strength and tenacity that will continue to serve us well, whatever the circumstance. And the extraordinary achievements we've seen in vaccine development provide reason for us all to be hopeful. We cannot let down our guard, but I know there are better times ahead. And I thank you, our Catamount family, for your perseverance and partnership.